The first Lao Aga Development Conference kicks off July, aiming to spread awareness about agarwood plantations among the farmers of Laos. According to Managing Director of Lao Aga International Development Company Limited, Sadiq Mohammed Chowdhury, the conference also focused on the projects that can be handled with cooperation of the Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry for the betterment of the nation. Speaking at the conference hosted by the Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry at Paksan District, Balikhamsai Province, sponsored and supported by Lao Aga International Development Company Limited and the HSMM Group, Deputy Minister of Agriculture and Forestry, Dr. Pet Pompipak, said the popularity of agarwood across Laos and pointed that there are many agarwood plantations in Balikhamsai Province, Vientiane Province, and Champasak, which altogether cover over 50,000 hectares of land. He said that it is essential to understand and learn about agarwood from the real-time experience and entrepreneurs and exchange information in regards to its production and marketing. The conference was also attended by Balikhamsai Provincial Deputy Governor Dr. Suvani Saisana, Indian Ambassador to Laos C. Goraj Rao, Mr. Sadiq Mohammed Chowdhury, Managing Director of Lao Aga International Development Company Limited, guests and representatives of the farmers of Laos.
The purpose of this conference is to spread awareness about agarwood plantation among the farmers of Lao PDR. We are strongly committed to farmer empowerment, technology transfer to farmer, and
in his remark, the managing director of Lao Aga International Development, Sadiq Mohammed Chowdhury, stated that certain issues must be resolved by the representatives soon so that it could provide income for farmers, which in turn can eradicate poverty and enhance their living standards. Future projects were also explained during the conference. Sadiq Mohammed Chowdhury said that HSMM Group is a good corporate citizen taking part in social causes in the Lao PDR and expressed confidence that the country will be developed with the cooperation of the farmers of Laos. He also briefed the vision of the company is to plant 1 million agarwood trees in Laos. Through this vision, the company wants to contribute to the fight against global warming. The company also planned to set up the first perfume factory in the Lao PDR by the end of this year. Later, the company also plans to set up an agar leaf tea manufacturing factory in the Lao PDR. The company is also in process of developing a diploma in horticulture with support from the National University of Laos and Nagaland University and Assam University from India. In addition, the company wants to create earning opportunities for the farmers of the Lao PDR. The company is devoted towards raising the livelihoods of the people in the Lao PDR, thus contributing to the socio-economic development of the country. Director General of the Biotechnology and Ecology Institute, Dr. Sri Udong Sundara, explained that the processes are undergone with utmost care in each level, starting from planting, providing necessary nutrients to plants, at plantation sites and during extraction. The quality of agar and difference in the quality in the international market is also reasoned.
Also, I am proud that an Indian company, HSMM Group, has invested and is running a successful business in the agarwood industry. It is also contributing to the economic development of Laos and also employment for the local people. So I'm very happy about it.
Later, Indian Ambassador to the Lao PDR, C. Goraj Rao, said that the HSMM Group is well known not only for their business approach but also for their charities, their contribution to socio-economic development of the Lao PDR, and for strengthening the ties between Lao and Indian businesses and entrepreneurs in Laos. The ambassador applauded the Lao workforce as resourceful and hardworking, mentioning that competition is stiff within the ASEAN region and survival of the fit will have strategies to derive the best output.
So I'm sure that with Laos manpower, which is quite resourceful and bright hard-working manpower and also the resources available. And the government is doing a lot of work in harmonizing these regulations and laws. Laos will be able to come out successfully, but this needs to be done on a proactive basis now, because the time left is very little. We need to move that, but I am confident that Laos will be able to come into Asian economic community very successfully.
We passed our technique to farmer, our technology to farmer, how to is plant and how to put in inject in the tree and how create the fungus, more fungus in tree.
According to Sadiq Mohammed Chowdhury, the country will be poverty-free only when farmers live a better life.
Lao people, Lao country is very good for plantation tree. We have in our country is too much tree, enough for tree is exporting quota for another countries like in Indonesia, Malaysia also, and Thailand also. But Lao is one country whose soil is so good and plant tree is demand is so high.
He mentioned that generating income and increasing the standard of living of the farmers by transferring technology is the key purpose of the Lao Agar Development Conference.